गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, इट्स माय प्लेजर टू बी हियर इन एसीपी इंडिया मीटिंग, एनुअल मीटिंग विच इज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय और गवर्नर डॉक्टर महेश्वरी अंडर द चेयरमैनशिप ऑफ डॉक्टर जयंत पांडा. आई एम थैंकफुल टू साइंटिफिक चेयरमैन एंड ऑर्गेनाइजिंग टीम फॉर इनवाइटिंग मी to deliver this important talk, that is orthostatic hypotension. Why we are concerned about it? This is one of the entity which can lead to sometimes fatalities related to autonomic dysfunction. But by the intervention of pharmacological and non-pharmacological maneuvers, we can improve the symptoms and the quality of the life of a person. It can lead to falls, fractures, syncope, acute coronary syndromes, heart failures, stroke, depression, limitation of physical activity, weakness, and exhaustion. As far as the prevalence is concerned, it increases with the age, but if the people who are having high blood pressure, systolic more than 160, the prevalence increases irrespective of age. Between the age of 65 to 69 years, it is 14.8%, and more than 85 years of age, it is 26%. But interestingly, only 2% patients are symptomatic. What is orthostatic hypotension or postural hypotension? A drop of systolic blood pressure of 20 millimeter or more, a diastolic of 10 millimeter or more, while assuming the upright posture. It could be initial or immediate, classic, delayed, or neurogenic. What is immediate? There is a transient fall of blood pressure which occurs within 15 seconds. It is associated with syncope or presyncope. Classic orthostatic hypotension is systolic fall of blood pressure 20 millimeter or more or 10 millimeter or more within 3 minutes of assuming upright posture. Delayed, there could be delay that it can occur after 3 minutes, and it may take about 20 minutes, 25 minutes, up to 45 minutes also to develop the symptoms. There is a fall of blood pressure of 20 millimeter of systolic or 30 millimeter in patients who are having supine hypertension, are 10 millimeter of diastolic. Now, what is neurogenic, which is a great concern today? It is subtype of orthostatic hypotension. It could be classic or delayed one, but that dysfunction is related specifically to the autonomic nervous system, not aggravated or precipitated by any environmental factors like dehydration or the drugs. Now, what is the pathophysiology? When we assume standing posture, there is a drop of pooling of circulation, pooling of blood about 500 cc to 1000 cc in the leg areas and flanking area, which leads to less venous return, less cardiac output, which in turn activates the carotid body and the baroreceptors, which are located around the large vessel, the aorta. The efferent goes to the hypothalamus, and then the efferent comes, which in turn increases the sympathetic activity and depresses the parasympathetic activity, which produces increased cardiac contractibility, increase in heart rate, increase in venous return, thereby increase the blood pressure and vascular resistance. So this is the mechanism which prevents the orthostatic fall of blood pressure. Out of them, it is the peripheral vascular resistance which is most important. Now, what are the causes of autonomic, neurogenic orthostatic hypotension? It could be at the central level, brain, synucleinopathies, multiple system atrophy, Lewy body dementia, Parkinson's disease, Wernicke-Karsdorff syndrome, bar receptor failure, oligopontine degeneration. At the level of the spinal cord, it could be due to trauma or syringomyelia. And peripherally, autonomic neuropathies could be acute or chronic. Most important one are acute Guillain-Barré syndrome, which we clinically see most of time, acute paraneoplastic autonomic neuropathies, autonomic neuropathy, botulism, porphyria, heavy metals, and drugs. Out of the chronic neuropathies, diabetes, amyloidosis, autoimmune autonomic ganglionopathy, pure autonomic failure, familial dysautonomia, HIV-related autonomic neuropathies, these are the most common. Now coming to the drugs, there is a huge list of the drugs, but worth mentioning are the antihypertensive drugs. Practically all antihypertensive drugs, they produce postural drop of blood pressure. But alpha blockers, alpha 2 agonistic, that is clonidine, methyldopa, vasodilators, hydralazine, and minoxidil, and diuretics, which are very commonly used, they produce orthostatic fall of blood pressure. Vasoactive drugs, nitrates, and phosphodiesterase 5 inhibitors, which are used for erectile dysfunction, antidepressants, and antipsychotic drugs. Drugs which are used for Parkinsonism, dopaminergic agents, levodopa, dopamine agnostic, anticholinergic drugs, they all can produce orthostatic fall of blood pressure. Now coming to the dehydration, it could be due to loss of blood, due to any reason, or loss of fluid. Loss of fluid could be because of vomiting, loose motions, excessive sweating, heat pyrexia and stroke, drugs, burns. And another interesting, working in the hot weather, exercise in the hot weather, they all produce loss of sweating and loss of fluid. Now, what are the clinical presentation? The most important, dizziness, vertigo, lightheadedness. Patient feels that something is being drained out. He feels sinking sensation, shortness of breath, chest pain as a result of myocardial hypoperfusion, neck cramping and standing. On standing, that is a coat hanger type of headache. It is as a result of hypoperfusion of the trapezius muscle and the shoulder girdle muscles. Retinal ischemia leading to visual blurring and loss of consciousness. Now, how to deal with these patients? How to approach? The most important is the history taking. Review all the medications which can produce orthostatic fall of blood pressure, relationship with the meals, relationship with the standing, working in the hot weather, exercise during the hot weather. Now coming to the physical examination, most important, the active standing test. This is a practical test, bedside test. Patient is advised to lie down for 5 minutes. His basal blood pressure and heart rate is recorded. Why heart rate? Because heart rate is very important during autonomic dysfunction. There is a blunting of the chronotropic compensatory response. Usually, when the person stands, there is an increase in heart rate by 10 to 15 beats per minute, which is not there, and it signifies autonomic dysfunction. Ambulatory blood pressure monitoring is another tool. It can detect orthostatic hypotension, white coat hypertension, nocturnal hypertension, and mask hypertension. And the head up tilt test, this HUT test, which is being done. When we think that patient is having orthostatic hypertension and we are not able to diagnose by other methods, then this test is being performed. There are special tables, HUT tables, which are lying in the air-conditioned room and available in the tertiary hospitals, not everywhere. Patient is made lie down for 5 minutes. He is connected to the cardiac monitor. He is strapped on the leg as well as the waist. That table is tilted to 60 to 70 degree, and the blood pressure and heart rate is recorded till the symptoms develop. Now, you can see this is vasovagal syncope, which is the initial one, initial orthostatic hypotension, and another is delayed one. Now, what are the guidelines? As per American Heart Association, neurogenic hypotension, acute water ingestion is class 1 indication. compression garments, counter pressure maneuvers, midodrine and doxydopa, these are class 2A indication. Increased salt and fluid, octrides and paracetamine, these are class 2B indication. If the drugs are the culprit, withdrawal or modification of the drug is class 2A indication. Dehydration is the cause, then acute water ingestion is class 1 indication, and reduce or withdrawal of the drugs class 2A, and increased salt and fluid intake class 2A indication. Now, what is the treatment? Removal of the reversible cause. The most important, the lifestyle change, the non-pharmacological measures are there. Education the patient regarding the aggravative factors which precipitate orthostatic hypotension. They should be removed, avoided, like warm ambient temperatures, hot baths, hot showers, straining, especially breath holding, that is Valsala maneuver, these should be avoided. At the same time, when the person changes the posture from supine to standing or sit to stand, he should be advised to have a pause. He should be cautious about it. The hot meals, especially carbohydrates associated with alcohol, they should be avoided for postprandial hypotension. Now coming to the physical maneuvers. Leg crossing, stooping, forward, squatting, straining of the muscles of the leg, thigh, up to the pelvic girdle, they all decrease venous pooling and increase cerebral flow and avoid the development of symptoms of postural hypotension. Now, physical activity is advised to all the people. Since it occurs mostly to aged men, the best is the morning walk and the light exercises. Now, another is the compressive garments. The use of custom-fitted elastic stockings, which are applied from the legs to the pelvic girdle, they minimize the peripheral blood pooling in the lower extremities and thereby reduce the symptoms of orthostatic hypotension. Postprandial hypertension. When there is a fall 20 mm of systolic of blood pressure, or person who is having basal blood pressure 100 mm systolic, and his blood pressure comes 90 mm or lower than that 2 hours after meals, this is postprandial hypotension. So it can be avoided by using large amount of meals, especially in carbohydrates, hot meals, and avoiding of alcohol. Patient should be advised to stand cautiously after taking meals. Now coming to the volume expansion. Patient is advised 2 to 3 grams of salt per day. Up to 10 grams of salt has been advised in some reports, but we have to be very cautious, especially in patients of chronic kidney disease and heart failure. Fluid intake should be 2 to 2.5 liter per day. Urinary output should be more than 1.5 liter per day. And urinary sodium excretion should be more than 170 milliequivalent per 24 hours. Now, sleeping with raised head. Patient is advised to sleep with 10 to 20 degree raised head. He can apply pillows, or 2 bricks can be put on either side of the head to raise the head. That helps in prevention of orthostatic fall of blood pressure. Now, the most important and class 1 indication, irrespective of the cause, is the acute water ingestion. Patient is advised to take 2 glassful of water within 3 to 4 minutes. It increases the pressure response and sympathetic activity, and thereby controls the blood pressure, thereby avoids the orthostatic fall of blood pressure. But there is a caution here. Person should not consume salt or sugar. Kehte na glucose ka pani pila diya. No, that reduces the pressure response and increase the flow in the splenic area, thereby may produce further fall of blood pressure. Now coming to the drugs, the most important is the fluorocortisone. It is a mineral corticoid drug, which helps reabsorption of sodium at the renal tubules and excretion of sodium, hydrogen, and potassium So the side effects are the hypokalemia, edema, supine hypertension, and headache. But the most important and the worst reaction is the adrenal suppression as a result of immunosuppression. Dose is 0.1 milligram per day, and the effect may last for a few weeks. It is the most commonly used drug. Now coming to the vasopressin, and they are antidiuretic hormone. Vasopressin is available in the form of nasal spray and the oral tablets. It is given at bedtime for the patients of nocturnal hypertension and who are having the morning symptoms. Now midodrine. Now it is available in our country. The active ingredient is desmoglomidodrine, which constricts the peripheral vessels and increase the peripheral vascular resistance. The side effects are supine hypertension, itching due to pyelomotor activation, a goosebump phenomena. Rongte khade ho jate hain. It is because of pyelomotor activation, urinary retention and headache. Dose is 2.5 to 10 milligram, 8 hourly. Another drug is doxidopa, which is metabolized by dopa carboxylase. It yields norepinephrine. Side effects are spine hypertension, dose 100 milligram three times a day. Other drugs are paracetamine, which is a reversible cholinesterase inhibitor. It improves orthostatic tolerance by increasing peripheral vascular resistance. Side effects are nausea, vomiting, abdominal cramp, sweating, salivation, and urinary retention. Octrides, it is used in patient postprandial hypotension. It constricts the splanchnic circulation by 20%. So to conclude my talk, ladies and gentlemen, orthostatic hypertension is associated with increased mortality and morbidity independent of underlying etiology. It increases the incidence of fall, fractures, syncope, especially in the elder population. Initial orthostatic hypertension, which is associated with syncope, should be taken care of. The drugs, which are the causative agents, they should be modified, removed, or stopped and changed, replaced. When supine to standing test is not possible, then sit to stand test is to be done. Education of the patients regarding lifestyle changes is very important. And water ingestion, 500 cc of water, 2 glassful of water is a remedy for all type of orthostatic hypertension, which improves the symptoms immediately, irrespective of the cause. Thanking you very much for your patience hearing.
Thank you, sir, for such a good talk regarding very important orthostatic hypertension. The time does not permit me to invite questions. I know that most of the questions are there, but you can ask Dr. Pritam Gupta, sir, individually, and I close the session.
Thank you, sir.